Hey there, Python trainer Ruben Lerner here. And this time I want to share with you a performance tip that is not super obvious when you are working with pandas, but that can have a huge impact on, well, on the performance of your analysis. So let's say I have a simple pandas series. I say S equals a series of 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. And I want to find out what is the largest number in that series. Well, I could say s.max. And what am I doing then? Well, I am running the max method that comes with pandas on my series, and sure enough, I get back 50. Not a surprising answer. But as someone in my corporate training yesterday pointed out, there is another way to do this. I could just run max on s, and I get the same answer. The thing is, there's a huge difference between these two ways of doing it. In the first, what I'm doing is, once again, running the max method on the series. But in the second, I'm using the built-in Python function max. What's wrong? What's wrong with that? Well, the built-in function max works with any iterable in Python, which means that it will take whatever you give it, assuming it's iterable, and it will indeed iterate over it one element at a time, checking to see, has it found the maximum value yet? Has it found it yet? It has to go through all the values because you never know, maybe that last value is the largest one, which means that it's running a for loop. And running a for loop is a fantastic thing in Python. We do it all the time. It's efficient, it's great, it's wonderful, but it's terrible in NumPy and Pandas. You are never, ever going to get good performance in NumPy and Pandas if you use for loops. And here there's a for loop also, but it's behind the scenes, it's kind of hidden. So, given the option, should you use the built-in function or should you use the method? You should always choose the method because the method there, s.max, is not going to pull things out into Python one at a time, turning them into integer objects and then comparing them with previous integer objects. No, it's going to do this all at the C level, or you could even say below C level. It's going to do it at the fastest possible, lowest level of programming that we can in a high-level programming language. That's the big advantage of using something like NumPy or Pandas. Now, if you're not sure you believe me, let me try to prove it to you. So I'm gonna say here, a equals np random randint. I'm just gonna create a NumPy array here. And how many, I'm gonna say from 0 to 1,000. And I'm gonna say I wanna have 100 million values in there. So I've now created a random array. I'm not going to print out all the values there, but you can believe me that there are 100 million values, each of which is between 0 and 1,000. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to define two functions. I'm going to say def use np.max. I'm going to say here, let's do this, return a.max. And I'm going to say def use python max, return max of a. Now, a is a global variable, so we won't have any problem finding and using it. That's really okay. And once I've defined these functions, I'm then going to use the timeit functionality inside of Jupyter, which also exists outside of Jupyter, I should say. Timeit comes with a Python standard library and run use np.max. And what's going to happen now is my function is going to be run many, many, many times to double check how long it takes. And sure enough, we see it takes 68 milliseconds per run, plus or minus 58 microseconds. What if I then say timeit with use python max? How's that going to work? And you're going to see it's going to work a lot more slowly. Now, this is with 100 million elements. Do you always have 100 million elements? No. Often you're going to have many fewer, in which case you won't feel or see the difference between these. But when you do have a lot of elements, boy, it's really going to hurt. Now, I'm using NumPy here, but you can equally easily use a series here. And we're going to do that in just a moment, just to sort of double check that is indeed that much slower to use a Python max. But I think you're seeing already, and granted, you can't judge necessarily between but based on how much time it is using, because if it takes less time, it often does more loops. But we are waiting. Oh, there we go. Look at that. It's 4.8 seconds as opposed to 68 milliseconds. Just to remind you, there are 1,000 milliseconds in 1 second. So what it's saying is that this took 4860 milliseconds, right, versus 68 milliseconds. That's a lot slower. I think we can all agree. Now, what about if I do this in pandas as opposed to in NumPy. Is it going to be the same sort of thing? Well, let's do a s equals a series of these things. We'll create the series there. And now I'm going to do exactly the same thing as before, but instead of using a, I'm going to use s. Okay, and we'll still call the function the same thing. So what happens when I do time it now on use np.max, which is really using, pandas max? Ooh, the suspense is killing me. Okay, and we see it's about the same, 68.5 milliseconds. What happens when I do it with the Python max function? Well, while this is running, we can go make a cup of coffee or something. While this is running, I want to stress, I'm not saying that Python is bad. I'm not saying the max function is bad. I'm saying that when you are working in NumPy or in Pandas, doing a loop is bad, and especially pulling data out one at a time into Python data structures is bad, slow, something you should really, really not do. You should avoid it. And it's usually obvious when you're running a for loop, if you're using for, but it's not obvious if a function you're calling, especially a built-in function, is running a for loop, which is going to happen if you do min, if you do max, if you do sorted, any of those things that has to go over each of our data structures. So we see here, this is indeed taking quite some time. I don't know if you can hear it. My computer's fan is also working up a sweat a little bit. All right, and pretty soon we will get our answer, and I think we will all agree that it's taking way, way, way longer. So while we wait for that, bottom line, oh, there we go, 7.28 seconds. Now, I'm not an expert in benchmarking, but I think even I would say that here it's pretty darn obvious we should use the methods and not use the Python built-in functions. All right, I hope this is useful and interesting to you. If you have questions, comments, anything you want to know about Python or pandas or related topics, send them to me. I'm on Twitter, I am on email, and if you want hints and tips about Python every week, join about 20,000 other people around the world for my Better Developers list. Thanks for watching. I should add, thanks to a user comment, I am now uploading all of my Jupyter notebooks from these videos to my GitHub repo. So go there, check it out, enjoy, play with it on your own, and I'll see you in the next video.